This is the Sanat Kumara. Welcome back to my lecture at Namas University, Earth Spiritual Digital University. The place and community that grows you into fully soul-guided and Shambhala-assisted human beings, able to create the life you are supposed to live and the future of Earth according to the divine plan. I hope you have had a wonderful time of insights with the Master Teachers Joshua, Maitreya and Mother Mary. During the month of April, it is my turn again to provide you with the broader context in which your life unfolds and with it leading you through Volume 2 of my Chronicles as of next week. Today, in Lecture 13 of 2023, I will talk about the context in which you are learning, creating and evolving our universe. And I want to talk about spiritual growth in moving upwards in the dimensions of this universe and from this universe into the next. The combination might seem strange at first, but bear with me for some moments and you will be positively surprised. Remember, the more your consciousness and your library of mind expands, the better you can perceive and integrate your life into an ever-increasing reality way beyond what your five senses perceive in the third dimension. The dense physical body in which you have currently incarnated sets limitations, but there is still a lot of room to be filled with higher dimensional experiences, knowledge and understanding today that you can use wisely on your spiritual growth journey. When most of you think about our universe, you think of stars at the night sky, videos and pictures taken by research satellites and telescopes of our solar system, constellations and galaxies, in fact, trillions of them. The more scientifically oriented amongst you also ponder about time and space, dark matter, wormholes, supernovas, and maybe moving to Mars. But all of that is based on a three-dimensional reality approach. It is like taking an MRI scan of your brain. Each time you only get a thin slice, but never the whole picture. For that, you need to add higher dimensional knowledge and awareness. Today, I would like to move you beyond the thin slice and give you the whole picture that involves the you returning to the divine, to our Creator, sometime in the future. Now, first, let's look at our universe and how transition from one universe to the next occurs. Our universe is the intentional manifestation of the being we call the divine, the Creator, God, Allah, Brahman, or by many other names. As you learn and move upwards, so does the Creator. Part of that growing is learning within one universe and then moving on to the next universe. In fact, on your journey of return to the Creator, the divine spark that forms the core of your soul needs to reunite with the Creator. In order to achieve that, you need incarnations in 4 to 7 universes, depending on how efficient you learn together with the ever-growing group you evolve with. Those closest to reunification with the Creator are the great beings that give life to stars, planets, moons, and the cosmic communication system, for example. The great being Zongkrit, giving life to Earth, is an example. I am an advanced Deva being from Venus, who serves Zongkrit as the chief operating officer for Earth, and I am in my fourth universe. As part of the divine's creation, sparks with his qualities were spewed forth into the void. Their purpose was and is to learn, gather experience, and return to the Creator wiser than they were when they left, and thus enrich the Creator as well. The Creator has three aspects for each universe: a plan to be achieved, a body of manifestation, and thirdly, the will, the commitment, the intention to move forward with manifestation of all sparks of life contained within the body of the Creator. The plan is the total sum of everything the Creator intends to accomplish in this incarnation, in this universe. This equals your personal and planetary mission for the incarnations of an aspect of your soul. The body ranges from the tiniest particles to the whole universe, and it is structured in what we call monads. You could also call them containers that demarcate a particular unity of the divine sparks. These monads, these containers, are similar to a nesting Russian doll, a matryoshka. Each of these monads contains sparks to be manifested, sparks of life, sparks of the Creator that are unified in two ways: purpose to accomplish and path to take until reuniting with the Creator. Human souls belong to such a monad, a container, a nesting doll. Devas have their own monad, container, nesting doll. Khonri have their own monad, container, nesting doll. Until in higher spheres of development, they merge into larger monads. Humans and devas merge. Khonri and Oblan merge. When manifested effectively, human souls focus on activities and relationships that benefit the whole human family, that are serviceable to the path to unity. Qualities of the Creator that are manifested can be determined by working benefit for inclusion, respect, and unity. When the execution of a plan for a universe has reached a certain level of accomplishment, the Creator starts the breathing in process. As from this point onwards, travel groups will be formed to enter into cycles composed of learning, serving, and teaching. What each travel group learns and teaches in the breathing in phase, on the journey of return, is recorded in the cosmic libraries. When the Creator decides that what was supposed to be accomplished in a particular universe is completed, he halts the process and the universe closes. What is recorded in the cosmic libraries is transferred into the next universe as the starting point from which all will continue. What is the difference between the Akashic record and the cosmic libraries, you may think now? The Akashic Record records activities, decisions and actions in one universe of each member of each monad down to each individual soul with each incarnated aspect. The focus is on the individual. When a universe ends, the Akashic Record is not transferred into the next universe. By contrast, all cosmic libraries are transferred into the next universe as they contain information that is relevant to the entire universe. That includes localized information about galaxies, solar systems, and planets. It also includes records of each Journey of Return travel group's lessons and learnings in manifesting the qualities of the Creator. It also includes higher dimensional concepts learned on the travel group's journey segment just completed. The focus is on group, not on individuals. To put it differently, focus is on the flower, not on each individual petal. When a universe comes to a close, there's a period of rest. Very similar to the rest you take between breathing out and breathing in. Very similar to the rest you take between incarnations. Our universe and every celestial body in it, every life form, from space dust to a massive nebula, including you, all together form the body of manifestation of the Creator. The Creator emerges from a period of rest and begins another incarnation in a new universe. This experience begins with business left over from the previous universe, its prior existence. This is like you, a human soul manifesting with another aspect of your soul in another dense physical human body. The Creator gives life to your soul and therewith your incarnated aspect. But he also gives life to all other manifestations of his, from giant nebula to the cosmic communication system of the universe, to the smallest particle. The Creator of past, current, and future universes is a being in its own right and member of an equivalent of your soul family. Our Creator follows the same pattern as you do. He belongs to a family of peers, the equivalent of your and my soul family. Now I hope it is clear by now why you need to know and live your personal and planetary soul's mission, which is part of your soul's family's mission, which is part of your soul neighborhood's mission, your soul's community's mission, and then ever-growing units in the nesting doll that are based not on individual but on group purposes and later on group consciousness. You are part of a nesting doll, always. Please have that in mind. Communicating with your own soul and soul family is the beginning of the real you journey in this incarnation. Then you will move on to communicate with other beings in other monads, other containers of development in this universe, beings in other nesting dolls, to enter into the more complex reality of your planet, our solar system, our galaxy and beyond. All of that requires communication in higher dimensions than the third. How do you do that? With a cosmic communication system that the Creator established in the whole universe. Beings called Conries manage the cosmic communication system and the lines of communication. They keep the system clear, vibrant, functional, and alive. In addition, many of them actively assist soul families with effective communication between individual souls in various locations, as well as effective communication between soul families and soul neighborhoods. Now you can appreciate why reconnecting Earth to the first of the five main stations of the cosmic communication system in Aachen, Germany in May 2021 is such a big deal. And you can understand why those visiting the Octagon of Aachen Cathedral reap enormous benefits in moments of quiet openness to messages passed through the cosmic communication system. Finally, I still have two questions to answer about our universe posed by some of you at the end of February. First, what are black holes? Are they portals? No, they are not portals. They are dense matter from which a great being that gave life to it withdrew. The great being moved on, and the devas are in the process of dismantling the physical manifestation. The second question is, with respect to what or whom is time measured when we use the terms previous and current universe? Time is an auxiliary construct. Incarnated aspects of souls in the third dimension invented to make sense of things they otherwise can't comprehend. Zongkrid gives life to Earth for billions of years. I do my duty as the Sanat Kumara of Earth for millions of years. And you all may well live to become 100 years old. Despite of the time difference, you and I face the same challenges. Know what we are here to do, focus, and use every day wisely. To the Creator, however, time is irrelevant. And the higher you develop, the longer each learning period takes, at least from your current perspective. Think about the effects the lifestyle of the wealthier part of the human family causes to Earth and therewith to Zongkrid. Does Zongkrid give up faced with the challenges? No. Zongkrid keeps focused and patient, as do I. Relevant to the Creator is learning accomplished and serving others with what we have learned. Otherwise, this universe can't develop, and with it, the Creator would stagnate or even stand still. That is also the reason why we encourage you to learn. And by learning, I mean truly study, truly comprehend, and then put into action what you have learned in your own life, as well as share it with and teach it to others, if possible, in ever-growing groups. In my next lecture, I will take you on a journey into the cosmic communication system. If you have the possibility to read and look at the illustrations of Volume 2 of my Chronicles, God's Station in Aachen Cathedral before that, please do so. It will enhance your experience and library of mind before, during, and after the lecture. That is all what I wanted to tell you today. I love you all and I bless you all. This was the Sanat Kumara.